welcome back to Trailer Trash. This week we will be looking at The Happening.
Yeah, rerun Dwayne Wayne and the whole neighborhood, I guess, is back in a movie that's like, 25 years overdue.
Dave, did you even watch the trailer this week?
Should I have?
Yes, very much so.
Hey, hey, hey!
Look, just check it out. We'll be back in a minute 40. Pay close attention, okay?
Are we supposed to stop here?
What's going on? You can't just leave us here.
Sir, we lost contact.
With whom?
Everyone.
There appears to be an event happening. It's some kind of attack. The first stage is loss of speech.
Claire. Claire?
The second stage is physical disorientation. The third stage is fatal.
Attacks are spreading. Boston, Philadelphia.
Maryland.
That's all over the country.
Authorities are now feeling that a terrorist group being responsible is becoming less and less likely.
She says everyone's dead outside.
Really be happening?
We've all been there. You're riding on a train, trying to figure out why you ever remade Planet of the Apes, when all of a sudden the train stops short. A well-spoken young black train conductor tells you that the world is ending, and then leads everyone off into the forest, presumably to start a new country.
We get your secret propaganda message, M. Night. Vote for Obama, or all the trains will stop and we'll all die.
Anyway, so you're left there, gently caressing your own perfect abs, full of questions, right? Are they going to go forage for nuts and wild berries and come back? Well, what else will happen if I don't vote for Obama? Can I get a refund?
Then this trailer drops its first non-believable bombshell on you when Mark Wahlberg correctly uses the indirect object pronoun whom?
With whom?
Yeah, please, just whom are you trying to kid?
Not me, whom. I don't know what that meant. You've got to feel sorry for M. Night Shyamalan. Every time he sets out to make a movie, he has to write two movies. The cool one you thought you were watching, and then the shitty one that you slowly realize you're watching.
Yeah, I remember starting off watching The Village, but ending up watching Blind Girl's Trip to the Drugstore.
Instead of trying to write two crappy movies rolled into one, why not just write one good one?
Oh, that's such a good idea!
Right?
And don't get me started on Signs. The aliens were killed by water? How does a species that has mastered intergalactic travel fail to notice that the planet that they are going to attack is two-thirds covered in death juice? And then they touch down on it naked. I mean, who's running this invasion? It's like, General, there appears to be a problem with our invasion.
Not now, Corporal. I'm watching my story.
Yeah, but sir, you really should use your
force. Jesus, fine. Poisoned liquid falling from the sky. Are you stupid? Dismissed.
But sir,
dismissed. And bring me a glass of water while you're out there.
Right away, sir.
Well, for this trailer, the WTF factor is off the charts.
True, and I do deeply identify with the characters as they ask, WTF is going on? Why am I here? My life is totally unbelievable.
Well, I hope they aren't watching the trailer for clues, because baby, there ain't none. Whatever this event is, all that is clear is that it forces you to listen to the radio in the middle of a cornfield.
And the best part, Mikey, is that people can fly, albeit in just one direction.
Upwards?
Yeah, not quite.
Good enough for me.
Could this really be happening?
Yes, Marky, it is.
So run, Mr. Mark. Run for hope. Run for our future.
Run! And cover your ears or something, because something's trying to break into your house to, I don't know, do something to you or something.
Because this is an event, and it is a happening. This isn't just some regular occurrence.
Yeah, so make your way somewhere, sometime this summer, when something opens someplace.
All right, here's where I stand, and I'll try to be specific.
Thank God.
For a change. The Sixth Sense was an amazing movie, and I admit I was completely surprised by the ending, but I feel like that was something M. Night could only accomplish once, because now, I'm on it.
Yeah, ditto. I feel like I watch his movies now, and I'm just waiting for the twist.
But you lucked out this time, M., because I happen to be fascinated by end-of-the-world scenarios.
And lesbians.
So I will go, and lesbians. And I will go see your stupid movie, despite knowing that I will hate the ending. I don't like to admit it, but your vague trailer worked. I'll give it one rung grudgingly up.
Yeah, for me, it's like the old saying goes. When M. Night Shyamalan gives you lemons, pray that they are poisoned as you rub them in your eyes and stuff the rinds in your ears during the opening credits. I gotta agree, Sixth Sense was great, but I'm sorry, M. Your years-long assault on the institution of storytelling has wearied this warrior. I have to give this one rum down.
We'll see you next time on Trailer Trash.
Ooh. Yeah, and it'll be good, because we'll be reviewing something.
Oh, by the way, your girlfriend called and she said that she tested positive for something.
Oh, well, I better do something about that.
Yeah.